Hi everyone. Today we're going to be talking about Achilles tendinopathy and a lot of the misconceptions about tendinopathies. So starting with the simple things, the Achilles tendon basically connects the calf muscle complex to the heel bone. And during gait, through contraction of the calf muscles, the Achilles tendon causes plantar flexion of the foot. Now, one of the big misconceptions about Achilles tendinopathy is that it only affects the active part of the population, so especially people like runners. And whilst Achilles tendinopathy is fairly common in this part of the population, it can also affect sedentary people. Now, with Achilles tendinopathy, you may experience symptoms like stiffness, pain in the Achilles tendon, and swelling as well. And this gets us to the next misconception about Achilles tendinopathy. So a lot of people think, unfortunately, that that's swelling due to inflammation. But in fact, it's due to a cellular response. And that response causes water to enter the tendon and then lead to that swelling. So with that water entering the tendon, we end up with disorganization, degeneration of the tendon itself. Now, for the third misconception, we're looking at the fact that people think that resting is the best thing that you can do for Achilles tendinopathy. But unfortunately, this is not the case. When you have Achilles tendinopathy, after a short period of initial rest, we really want to get to loading the tendon. And it's that loading of the tendon that makes it more resistant to future loads that are placed upon it. Now, we do this loading and create a management plan that addresses risk factors that you have for Achilles tendinopathy. Now, that can include a lot of things. So one of the big ones is overuse. Other ones are tightness through the calf muscles, biomechanics, and things along those lines. So it's not really a one-size-fits-all approach for Achilles tendinopathy. What we want to do, again, is address those risk factors, but it really depends on where you're getting the tendinopathy. You can get tendinopathy through the mid portion of the tendon, or also where it inserts onto your heel. Now, a lot of people will think that stretching is a great thing to do for tendinopathy of the Achilles tendon. But if you do have Achilles tendinopathy, where it inserts onto your heel, that stretching can actually cause a lot more damage and really impair the healing response. So coming down to that, the best thing to do if you do have pain, stiffness, tightness of the Achilles tendon and swelling as well, is to come in, have an assessment done to address your risk factors and have an individualized management plan created for you. And that, again, may include things like stretching, addressing biomechanics, orthotics, certainly loading of the tendon. Other things we tend to do are things like dry needling to address that tightness through calf muscles, and potentially shockwave therapy as well. So we hope this helps.